Good morning. Today I'm going to talk about adding a video library to your SharePoint page. Not only that, but we'll go over the filtering options and how we can put our videos into different categories. Let's get started. Okay, so let's create our video library in SharePoint. Let's open up the SharePoint instance. And the first thing I want to do, I'm going to go into site content, and I've already created a video library, a document library. And the way that you do that is just select new and document library, give it a name and description and save it. And in this library, I'm going to store all the videos that I create for my coworkers to help explain the applications that I develop for them. So to record, I could do it in several different ways. You can use something like Camtasia or one of the other screen recordings or what have you. But I found that Microsoft Stream works really well in this situation. So I'm going to click on my app launcher icon here, and I'm going to go into Stream. Now, all these recordings are now in SharePoint. Microsoft Stream has moved over to SharePoint, if you don't know. The classic site is still available, but it will be going away. So, and I can choose upload, recording, or playlist. I'm going to choose recording because I wish to create a new recording. And you see me recording the recording in a recording. Okay. And this also has a lot of nice features like you'd find in Microsoft Teams, like for backdrops. Now, if I were to add this blur, it would blur on top of a blur because I'm using my Mac, which has the, I forget what they call it, the your device camera options. So we're not going to use that. Let me get out of there before I start rambling on more. I can record just audio. But let's go back to video. I can even record. I could just record my screen. Now, I don't need to do that with this, but that is another screen recording option that you have available to you. There's a bunch of different options here for drawing on your video as it goes along. You can add stickers if you like, and the different filters, and put a frame around it. And you can even do all sorts of other neat things, and add a photo within it if you wish. So a lot of nice features there, but this is not about Microsoft Stream. Let's go ahead. We got our countdown, and now I am talking to you in two different places, two different recordings. Let's stop that and let's go into review. I don't need to hear myself talk. I could trim. I don't know why it keeps play. I don't like the autoplay feature, but that is what we have there. Be quiet. Let's finish. Now, I could download it here to my hard drive and do whatever I need to do, but I don't really need to do that. And again, from here, I could share and copy. But let's look at where this has stored my recording. It has put the recording by default into my documents folder. This is already on my hard drive. So, but what I want to do, I don't want to fill up my hard drive. I'm going to go ahead and move this into my SharePoint instance, which the quick access was so nice to have it automatically up, and going to my video library. That is a really nice feature. So I'm going to move that video here. Let's, the indicator is there. Let's stop this from playing. And I am going to close him and then go back over to my video library. Let's refresh. There's my latest recording. And I'm going to rename this to 3. Creative. Okay. So now I could show this on an individually on a page or as a group. Let me show you. Let's close that so I don't confuse myself. Let's go into the site pages. This is my video library. And let's put it in edit mode. And you could change this banner here if you want, but let's talk about the videos for right now. There is a stream web part. This is for the classic. In this instance, this won't work for us. You could also do embed. But there again, you have to put this into an iframe and do all sorts of stuff. You have to change the embed code. Let's instead choose file and media. And I'm going to choose that recording, that latest one. And put that there. So now we have a single video on our SharePoint page. But we want to show all the videos. We can't use file and media because that only shows one video at a time. I would not use stream web part because that goes to the classic stream site, which is now deprecated and will be going away. I am not going to talk about the embed, but instead let's choose highlighted content. This will show all of documents, videos, everything that's on my site. But I'm going to use the filter function here. And I'll choose a document library on this site and then choose my video library. Now I have a listing of all the videos that I put into that document library. In the next segment, I'll show you how to filter this out so that you can base what videos are shown based on a classification of the video. I'll show you how to do that in the next segment. Okay, now we have our single video, and we have our library of videos on our page. But you'll notice that I've got two other videos here, and I'd like to put those into their own category, their own section, and those are Power App applications. So let's put these two videos into this section here. First, let's go into edit. Then we'll go all the way down here and we're going to add the highlighted content again. But before we do that, let's go over in here. Let's add another column and it's just going to be a text column. And this is going to be category. See where I'm going here? And it's going to be a choice column. And the first one will be, let's say SharePoint. The second will be Power Apps. I'm going to change that to the purple. That is the Power Apps. And then the third, let's make that, how about Angular? And then we'll put in React. And I think that's enough for right now. And let's save. And we'll go ahead and put this in edit grid view. And let's change it to Power Apps. This will be Power Apps. This will be SharePoint and SharePoint. And that's good enough. Let's exit. Okay. So let's go back over to the video library. Choose edit. And we are going to use our document library once more and our video library. Now we're going to come down here to the filter and sort. And we're going to base this on the title. And we're going to look for Power Apps. And we see that doesn't work. So let's go by column name. And that column name is category. If I could type. And I don't know why I didn't find it, but okay. Contains, let's just put contains and Power Apps. And we will just leave it the way it is and let's republish. And now we have our videos by category. You know what? I want this up at the top. So I am just going to grab this handle here. And we're going to put this under the main. And republish. So now we have our hero image, our hero video by category, and then all of our videos for our coworkers to view at their leisure. So if you found this video helpful in any way, shape, or form, I'd appreciate if you click the like button or even become a subscriber. Until next time, have a great day.